58. Tremendous right. body, and still he has that great speed.
Well, as you say, I tell you, and his size and his looks are distinctive, Lance. He's bigger than he looks, as you say, 258 pounds, and all those muscles are proportioned just in the right places, and he's got plenty of them. As you mentioned, a former Mr. Minnesota, a tremendous amount of athletic ability and agility and wrestling knowledge to go along with it. Just an outstanding competitor.
Z-Man, hey, he's going to have a part in that Halloween Havoc coming up in a couple of weeks. He's going to be in there against Mike Rotunda, and that should be some kind of interesting rough and tough match that'll be a part of the October the 28th Saturday night happenings. Look at Z-Man with a big arm bar right now on Richard Sartain, who is no small fry himself. He drives Z-Man into the corner, putting that shoulder to the midsection three times, grabs him in a whip as he takes him out, and Z-Man showing that agility, Bob, up over the top, and he hip tosses him down, finally hooks that arm, takes him over and under and right back into the arm bar.
And I tell you, he's got a lot of speed and a lot of power behind those arm drags and those hip tosses. Fans, again, let me remind you about the Thunderdome. We talk about the top of that 30-foot cage, that square cage, 16 feet high, electrified.
Electrified.
And Lance, falls do not count. You can't give up. You can't quit. The only way the match is going to be, it's not going to be won, it's going to be lost, is when your second throws in the towel. And just think about it. You know, you got Ric Flair with the figure four. You got Sting, you know, with that scorpion hold of his. You got Terry Funk in there.
With
and you got Muda.
Rider.
Yeah, you got
all
Muda, all
the
of
nerve holes.
Oh,
and
absolutely.
All that.
You know, each one of them can cripple a man in just a matter of seconds.
You're talking about going to be a rough and tumble match, Bob. Maybe we ought to say that while Halloween Havoc is going to be great family entertainment,
yeah,
for this final match, we might have a little parental discretion advised. Maybe for the youngsters, you might want to watch and not let them watch this particular match.
Yeah.
Oh, look at the Z-Man. Moves around behind. Hooks him in that sleeper. He's got the power and the height to do it, too. Referee Tommy Young, as Richard Sartain fights to try to get himself loose. I don't believe he's going to be able to make it. All kind of pressure being applied to that nerve point on the side of the neck. And that's going to be it. The bell to be tested.
Well, he got that sleeper on Sartain, and he had it locked in tight, and there was no way he was going to get out of that. And he went right out of there, Lance.
He got that carotid artery with plenty of pressure being put in right down on it. As the Z-Man, Tom Zink, makes it a definite yes when it comes to saying, can he do it? The Z-Man is the newest
Minnesota, former Mr. Minnesota, as a matter of fact, but the ladies have very adeptly named the Z-Man. Sends Greg Evans inside, upside down, and Evans back underneath, shows great quickness, but the Z-Man too powerful. Great drop kick by the Z-Man.
Ask him.
Evans is close to going unconscious.
Ask him.
A very dangerous hold. Hope he stops very quickly, and yes, it is. He's stopping it.
The winner of the match, the Z-Man.
As we will look closer at Halloween Havoc coming in just 2 weeks, as the Z-Man wakes up, Greg Evans gets that flow of blood going back to the brain. It's been a great hour, and we will have more for you right here on this great television station for our whole crew. I'm Jim Ross saying so long, everybody.
And we're going to hurt you October 28th.
Robin, I want to give you a hug.
Real muscle man, no doubt about it. He's actually very deceptive. He's big, he's strong, and he's very powerful, but he's very agile and quick in the ring, and I think that's the thing about it. And by the way, Halloween Havoc, as we mentioned, just a little, you know, approximately a week away. That's right. And Mike Rotunda is going to find out a lot about the Z-Man in that match.
Is that going to be interesting when the captain gets in there with the Z-Man? Lee Scott hanging on to a side headlock, not for long. Good shoulder. Scott puts him down. Over the top goes the Z-Man. Look at that. That's that agility and a drop kick to just punctuate what Bob was saying.
Well, I tell you, when you got that size and you got all of that ability and that true athletic ability to go with it that this man has, I tell you, it's hard to handle.
This guy's a former Mr. Minnesota.
Yes, sir.
Well, it doesn't seem fair that he should have all of that. To hear we say, he takes him over and Lee Scott is down. Z-Man, what an impressive debut a couple of weeks ago right here in the NWA, and he is really looking good. Comes off the rope. That's what he loves.
Yes, sir.
He loves that sleeper hold, goes for the pressure on that carotid artery, and he is strong enough and big enough to make it stick on almost anybody he clamps it on. Referee checking to see if Lee Scott's had it. He raises a hand again. He's about to decide. It's all over. And there it is. The bell sounds.
And ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, the Z-Man!
Yes, sir. And when he came with that sleeper hold and he had that locked in tight, there was no way Lee Scott was going to get out of it. And fans, right here, we can take a look at the Western Union replay as the Z-Man is going to get, as the Z-Man puts him to sleep. Western Union.
The Z-Man! His tag team partner, hailing from Cincinnati, Ohio. He weighs 228 pounds, Lion Bryan.
And what an ovation for these two young stallions here in the NWA. Lion Bryan of Air Pillman and Tom Zeke, the Z-Man, to take on the Cuban Assassin and Richard Sartain. And Sartain and the Assassin starting out very quickly on these two handsome youngsters here on the NWA main event.
Well, Jim, I guess the Cuban and Sartain, they figured discretion would be the better part of being stupid and decided to go full bore at them. But Zink, the Z-Man, and Flying Bryan had other plans. They're too quick and too powerful.
I have to reflect back on what we heard just moments ago from Nature Boy Ric Flair, from Flying Bryan, those pre-recorded comments from Sting, and more importantly, from Ole Anderson, a man that is known to have a very, very black heart, a man that has amassed a winning percentage that is beyond parallel in this sport, and many of those victories came with his partner Gene Anderson of the Minnesota Wrecking Crew by submission. He knows all about pain. He knows all about how far you can go before it's the breaking point, and how far will he let it go at Halloween Havoc. How far will Gary Hart let it go before one of those men throw in the towel?
All the players are here. They have been identified. Ole Anderson, a crueler, a more evil, a more despicable, a black-hearted individual, has never walked the earth as Ole Anderson. One of the ways that he and his brother Gene won the World Tag Team title once, he sacrificed his own brother. He told me that himself. He's an evil man, Ole Anderson. But at the same time, he was a great in professional wrestling. He knows how much these men can take. Gary Hart, a manager, no compassion for anybody, including his own men. He might not care how much his own men can take. The whole thing boils down to the men in the ring cannot submit. They can scream, "I quit," all night long. It's the guy in the corner that has to terminate the match, and who knows what they're liable to stand for.
And we'll talk much more about that when we see Ric Flair and Sting later in the program here on the NWA main event with our colleagues Bob Caudle and Lance Russell. High move there by Flying Bryan, and he and the Z-Man double hip locking Richard Sartain, and Flying Bryan taking Sartain over with an arm drag right into the arm bar. We will take a look later in the program of the situation involving Lex Luger and Flying Bryan. They will be competing for the United States Heavyweight Championship on Saturday night, October the 28th in Philadelphia.
And Flying Bryan and the Z-Man so far making an effective combination is Fist Bryan. He is a gutsy kid. He'll fight you. He's a heck of a nice guy outside the ring, but he's all business inside it. You can see by the concentration on his face, and he comes up with some maneuvers, brother. And look at that one.
Great drop kick by the Z-Man as Flying Bryan had Sartain elevated there. The Z-Man in his first big confrontation in the NWA as he will challenge the outstanding athlete from Syracuse, Mike Rotunda, at Halloween Havoc. For you fans that are watching our broadcast in Philadelphia, tickets are still available but going very rapidly, and they're on sale now at all Philadelphia area Ticketmaster outlets, and that includes the Civic Center box office in Philadelphia.
The Z-Man, he's now being pounded by the Cuban Assassin, and like you said, the Z-Man going up against Rotunda at Halloween Havoc, and Rotunda's been there. He's been a champion, TV take out a former champion in the NWA to see if he's got what it takes. He wants to prove it to himself and to all of his fans. Flying elbow by Eric Pillman, the former Cincinnati Bengal, is really cooking on all cylinders. Right hand, and Sartain fighting back, but to no avail, as Flying Brian and the Z-Man, too much. Oh, gosh, what a double drop kick, almost beheading Sartain. These guys have been perpetual motion since the first time they got into the ring. Now Z-Man sending Sartain in again. He has been whipped, kicked, floundered, slammed, dropped, flopped, and stretched. And he is barely able to get up off the mat. Look at Pillman poised. Here comes Eric Pillman. He runs the high wire, the flying clothesline for the middle of the top rope. Pillman and the Z-Man are ready for Halloween Havoc.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, the team of Flying Brian and the Z-Man.
You saw those smiles, Jim Ross. It looks like a Pepsodent commercial out there, the Z-Man and Flying Brian, but they're effective. And look at this maneuver. Top rope, in the middle of the rope. Look how springy it is. It takes perfect balance and beheads Richard Sartain with that dynamite clothesline.
Fans, the NWA main event will continue after this.
Lex, push back your seat backs and your tray tables. Fasten up your seat belts, because just one more week, Halloween Havoc is upon us. And what I want you to do, when you're 30,000 feet high up in the blue sky, pull out that Louis Vuitton bag, take out that vanity mirror, and take one last look at the reflection of perfection. Because I'm going to be up in the cockpit, brother, and I'm going to press a button called ejection. It's going to be your biggest enemy, because we all know what goes up.
With us in Philadelphia Live, call your local cable company for program availability. This is going to be a match, Christopher, of quickness and expertise versus size and bulk. And the Z-Man and Flying Brian have got to keep it up tempo to have a chance in this one against the Militia.
Clearly the Militia can outpower these two, but there's no doubt that Pillman and the Z-Man can outfly the two of them. Pillman in there now with Jackal Victory. No doubt Jim Ross, he'd like to be in there with Lex Luger.
No doubt about it, tag was made though. The Z-Man's in, what an outstanding athlete he is.
Just drops, absolutely drops Jackal Victory down.
He's a very strong, agile young man, is the Z-Man. Tom Zink, former Mr. Minnesota. The ladies have called him the Z-Man.
And Pillman now in there with a bit of a flying knee right into Jackal Victory's chin there. And a big chop there from Pillman.
Those are Ric Flair-like chops by Flying Brian. And Eric Pillman can really fly.
That is why they call him Flying Brian, fans. He's ready for more action. Jackal says, wait a minute.
You're right, Chris. I'll tell you something. Pillman would love to see Luger in the ring right now instead of the New Zealand Militia. Certainly Luger is a lot more attractive to compete against than Rick Morgan.
And a quick tag there. Zink back in there. Zink and Pillman, to my knowledge, have never teamed up, but it seems that they really know how to work with one another.
Rick tagging in very quickly indeed.
Pillman up high, just jumps right over Rick Morgan. Double team there, and Morgan flat on his back. Pillman in with an arm bar.
Pillman's big advantage right here, obviously, is his agility and his quickness to keep Morgan at bay, who's about 280.
Yep.
He's got to keep him at a disadvantage here and use that quickness. That's what he's doing right now.
Reversal, another reversal there, and Pillman back on top now.
Lion Brian, former member of the Cincinnati Bengals, knows what it's like to get down in the trenches. He was a linebacker for the Bengals, still has a close relationship with many of the Cincinnati players, including quarterback Boomer Esiason. They're very good friends. I know they'll be rooting for Flying Brian in Philadelphia. I know they wish they could be there.
And Rip Morgan now backed into the corner. Pillman flings him into the ropes. There's the Z-Man, and Morgan says, no way. A drop kick there from Pillman. Body slam by the Z-Man. Morgan up high. He's down. An elbow drop. Big one from Pillman.
Halloween Havoc's the Super Bowl of wrestling fans. Again, if you can't be with us live in Philadelphia on October the 28th, be sure to call your local cable company for program availability.
And Morgan recovers enough, a big, big left forearm to the back of Tom Zank. Zank backed up into the turnbuckle now. A couple of shots to the stomach and a reversal there. Morgan into the turnbuckle. Zank flies right in with a high head scissors, flips Morgan out of the turnbuckle. Morgan not quite sure where he is. Zank goes for the same move, and Victory with that boomerang.
Well, the referee was detained with Flying Brian and did not see the boomerang used on the head of Tom Zink, the Z-Man.
That will change the flow of this match immediately.
Momentum has certainly turned into the corner as the crowd here becoming somewhat irate of the antics and tactics of the New Zealand militia. The Z-Man being choked into near unconsciousness by... And right there, a cheap shot. It's Jacko Victor.
You can see the effects of that boomerang to the back of the head there. Zink looks a bit out of it now. Morgan flings Zink into the ropes. Elbow to the shoulder there. It goes for the cover. He's got two and almost three there. Zink just barely able to kick out.
Zink's got great power. He's a very strong young man, and Morgan did not break behind the leg. Might have prevented it. The pin if he had done so, but we got a double team tactic. Anytime the referee's back is turned, the veteran team of Morgan and Victory are going to bend the rules.
And there goes Zink face first into the mat. As we said earlier, Jim, certainly Zink and Pillman working very well for just teaming up this first time, I believe, but the New Zealand militia have teamed up for quite a lot longer, and they're clearly going to have the advantage in tactics. They know how to manipulate the referee.
Well, the New Zealand militia have got to keep Lion Bryan and the Z-Man at a disadvantage right here with Zink off his feet. Can't use those high-flying tactics, the high-impact maneuvers. And the New Zealand militia, Chris, are controlling the tempo.
Pillman stretching. There's the tag, and Pillman is in.
The referee didn't see it. He's not going to allow it. He didn't see it.
And then back out a wide-open Tom Zink. A shot by Rick Morgan. Zink thrown into the ropes now. And Morgan slams him.
That's a bear hug slam there. And the high impact moves with a lot of power and velocity, what the New Zealand militia like. Near fall here.
And again, failure of the grapevine behind the leg costs Morgan that match.
Morgan just laying on the Z-Man. That's not going to be enough to pin him. But they're trying to wear him down here. And they've got to keep Flying Bryant at bay, outside. And if they can, they'd like to keep the Z-Man in this match for the duration and not allow him to make the tag. That's classic tag team strategy.
And they've certainly done that so far, Jim Ross. Morgan now backs Zink into the ropes, flings him in the ropes again, but it appears that Zink recovers somewhat. Morgan off balance, he's got him. That's two, but Morgan kicks out. Zink still suffering the after effects of that incredible boomerang, that heavy wooden or metal boomerang to the back of the head. Right to the eyes there. You can see that Zink's eyes barely open.
Double team move here. Jacko's a legal man in the ring. Kick right to the back of the head of Z-Man.
Zink almost out on his feet now. Does not look good for the team of Tom Zink. Now the Z-Man and Lion Bryan. Obvious chokehold there. And snapmare over Jacko Victory with a reverse chin lock now on Tom Zink. This may provide some opportunity for Zink to catch his breath at least, Jim.
Well, I tell you, the way he's got the neck crimped there, Chris, it really restricts the flow of blood to the brain. It's almost like Zink's, the same philosophy as Zink's sleeper. And Zink will be tested at Halloween Havoc as he steps in the ring with Captain Mike Rotunda as Flying Bryan leads the cheer here. Phenomenal crowd here in West Palm Beach, Florida.
Yeah, great crowd here in West Palm Beach. And Zink looks to have recovered just a bit. Now both Victory and Zink are on the mat. Zink clearly the worst for wear. Victory is about to tag Morgan. He's got it. And at the same time, holds on to the Z-Man's leg.
That was a good move by Jacko Victory to prevent the tag of the Z-Man. He held on to the ankle. Remember, he's got a five count to leave the ring. He used the count to its full effect and prevented the tag. That's what he was there to do.
Big body slam. Now a leg drop.
I'll tell you something, Chris. If the militia does, if they don't make a mistake here, lateral press, if the militia doesn't make a mistake, they're going to win this match.
Can't argue with that. Back now into the reverse chin lock. Almost a chokehold there. Referee Tommy Young checking it out.
A move like this where you're leaning on the man, taking away the oxygen, all 280 pounds of Rick Morgan riding the neck of Tom Zink. It adds a lot of pressure and a lot of impetus to the already strong arm around the neck, but he's leaning on it. That takes away from the oxygen. He's got to carry, Zink's got to carry his weight and Morgan's. Zink has got to get up to a vertical base to relieve the pressure.
And he's up just about now, and it looks like the cheers of the fans helping Zink out now. There they are, the great NWA fans here in West Palm Beach. A couple of shots of the elbow doesn't do too much there to Rip Morgan. Morgan backs the Z-Man into the turnbuckle, flings him back in, and misses.
He threw it to the neutral corner away from Flying Bryan, but he made the mistake I was talking about. The Z-Man's got to make the tag here. If he does, this will
be the
team.
And Pillman in with an incredible high dropkick. Victory down. Pillman flings Victory into the ropes.
technical victory. Victory with a rake of the eyes. Hellman and his partner, the Z-Man, now bump into each other. No, Hellman jumps over his partner. But Zink is left inside the ring. Hellman leapfrog, but he was knocked out of the ring by Jacko. Now it's Zink, the Z-Man, in there with both guys. It don't look too good. It doesn't look good right now for the Z-Man. Zink comes up somewhere, somehow, with a double clothesline. Both members of the New Zealand militia go down. Zink, after Jacko, he's got his sleeper hold. The Z-Man has his sleeper hold on Jacko Victory. And Morgan breaking it up.
But remember, Flying Brian's the legal man in the ring, as is Jacko Victory.
A big flying body press. This should be it. Hooks the leg. It's green.
Wrestling fans, the winner of this very special tag match, the Z-Man and
Flying Brian Pillman.
What a victory. The Z-Man will face Mike Rotunda at Halloween Havoc and Flying Brian in his Super Bowl against Lex Luger for the United States Championship. It was high risk all the way. And this is what Pillman wants to do against the total package. He has championship on his mind, and my money is